I'm always looking to expand my tools and capabilities in my small one-car garage shop. Recently, I looked into getting a CNC and or dial laser for the shop. And after much research and YouTube watching, a dial laser made by Xtool got my attention. Meet the Xtool D1 Pro 20 watts. The D1 Pro 20 Watt is the newest addition to the Xtool line of dial lasers. This desktop dial laser is offered in two different colors, the smooth, silky gray that I have right here. And if you guys know me, you know that I like gray. They also have this awesome looking red and gold that kind of gives out Iron Man vibes. The first thing that came to mind when looking for a dial laser was how difficult is it going to be to assemble and how long is it going to take me? Well, Xtool did an amazing job packaging the D1 Pro, and the instructions are very well put together. If you are like me and are a visual learner, you will appreciate the very detailed pictures in the instruction book. The rails come pre-assembled for the most part, so you don't have to worry about putting that together. The assembly is very straightforward, and it took me maybe about 45 minutes while also filming, so it will definitely take you a lot less time to get it done. The D1 Pro is able to provide a 20 watt laser by using four individual 5 watt lasers that combine to output a 20 watt dial laser at the end of your machine. Not only is this thing powerful with the 20 watt output laser, but it is fast. The D1 Pro has a 400 millimeter working speed, and that will save you time when cutting or engraving. If you plan on using the machine to batch out products like I do, then this is a big deal. The time it takes to engrave or cut is significantly lower compared to other desktop dial lasers in the market. And we all know, time is money. But the machine that moves that quickly, you might think that it won't be as precise, right? Well, Xtool claims when cutting and engraving, the D1 Pro accuracy is 4/100ths of an inch, which basically translates to saying that it's really, really accurate. If you're a complete beginner to laser engravers like I am, the D1 Pro has limit switches on the X and Y axis. This will ensure you don't break or damage your new toy by ramming it into itself. An alarm will trigger when the laser is about to hit any of the boundaries of the machine. Another reason why limit switches are a big deal is that you can auto-home your machine. This is great for batching out stuff like I plan on using it. As long as I set my material in the same location, I can rehome it after every use and I'll know it will cut or engrave in the same spot. Instead of using cheap limit switches, Xtool decided to use these contactless limit switches, and to be completely honest, I don't know exactly how they work. So I reached out and asked Xtool, and apparently when the probe on the limit switch detects the limit baffle on the machine, the alarm will trigger. Setting up the laser height to engrave is super easy. On the right side of the laser, you have this arm that flips out. Just adjust your laser height until the arm is touching your material. For cutting material, you will use the small scale right next to the arm to adjust it for your material thickness after you set the laser to the correct height. The way you move the laser up and down is actually very smart. On the left side of the laser, you untighten this little tab, and on the back of the laser, it has this dovetail slot that the laser rides on to glide up or down. Flame detection should be mandatory in all laser engravers, and shout out to Xtool for actually having this flame detection system on the new D1 Pro. I don't know if you guys know, but wood is flammable, and shooting a hot laser on it might not be the best idea. Again, not really sure how it works, but as long as it works, I'm good. Along with fire detection, the D1 Pro has gyro sensors, meaning that if for any reason, maybe you accidentally bump into it, or if a UFO decides to come down and levitate the laser engraver, the machine will stop itself and shut off with the help of the sensor. I really like that Xtool is looking out for their user safety. Dude, you're just reading what's on the website. What? No, I'm not. Let's talk about the size of the machine. If you're like me, space is at a premium in your shop. The Xtool D1 Pro has a footprint of 23.25 inches wide by 23.5 inches deep. It is also 3.5 inches tall with the standard kit. I do say standard kit because Xtool sells extension kits that will double your engraving area. They also have risers that will rise your machine. Each riser will give you 45 millimeters, or if you like to woodwork in hard mode, about 1.77 inches more working area underneath. This is essential if you plan on using the rotary accessory. Xtool was also kind enough to send me the RA2 Pro, a rotary accessory that will enable me to engrave curved or round objects. The RA2 Pro is like four different tools in one. The roller rotary. This is primarily used when engraving irregular cylinders such as wine glasses, tortilla rollers, and such things. The chuck rotary. This is great for mugs, tumblers, wooden dowels, or anything you could fit in the chuck. The sphere rotary. It's pretty much self-explanatory, but it's used when engraving round objects like golf balls, baseballs, Christmas ornaments, and such things. The ring rotary. I never really thought about this, but the RA2 has a ring rotary for ring engraving. How cool is that? Xtool also sent me the air assist set. The purpose of the air assist is to get a clean cut edge during engraving or cutting. The air assist helps blow away the smoke and residue. The air assist kit comes with everything you need to add it onto an older system like the Xtool D1. But the new D1 Pro that I have here comes with the air assist accessories already attached. I didn't need all these extra parts. The pump feels quality, and it doesn't sound too loud because of the little rubber feet at the bottom. It also doesn't move around with the vibration. I will say, I'm not really a fan of it having its own power cable. I now have to dedicate two outlets for one machine. The cable management for the Xtool D1 Pro itself is really good. They have dedicated holes for zip ties that tuck away the cables. But for the air assist tool, there's really no cable management, so the hose is just everywhere. Now that's just me nitpicking, but it's worth mentioning. I do want to give a big thanks to Xtool for sending me the Xtool D1 Pro 20 Watt, the air assist set, and the RA2 Pro to make this video possible. If you guys are interested in any of these products, I will leave a link down below in the description. And if you want to see more tool reviews, check out this video.